Hi there, everybody. It's Mathea Ford with Renal Diet HQ, and I'm going to do a live today. I wrote a new blog post this week, so I wanted to talk to you about it and kind of go over the review the blog post. It's talking specifically about eGFR, GFR, glomerular filtration rate. So if you want to make a comment, if you have any questions, please comment. I hope that I can see them all. I'm using StreamYard, so it can be a little bit funky sometimes. But let's get into this and let's talk about what is eGFR. Does it mean that you have kidney disease or is something else going on? I want to go through what the test is, what it measures, and what you can do to improve your or impact your test results for your kidney health. So first of all, I should tell you what is eGFR, which is estimated glomerular filtration rate. In a nutshell, it's like an equation based on several factors. They use a blood test. It is designed to estimate how much blood passes through your glomeruli are the things that they're tiny filters in your kidneys that filter the waste from the blood. So your kidneys have nephrons. They're a filtering organ. And inside those nephrons are a lot of these little mini filters that the blood passes through. The waste is pushed out, and that's what makes urine. And then your body actually recovers some fluid and some other things from that and puts it back into your body. They're an excellent organ, obviously do lots of important things. They remove excess waste and fluid from your body. And that glomerulus is the part of the filtration system that the eGFR is measuring. And you'll see people refer to it both ways, GFR, eGFR. eGFR just means estimated. They use the formula. It is a indication of kidney function, of renal function. And below me, I have the information about my test, my course that is all about kidney test results. So you can go to renaldiethq.com, and at the top there's a link to Understanding Kidney Test Results course. That is a course, and I talk about not only eGFR, but also all the other blood tests that you can have done for kidney disease, what it means, what you can do to change that, what's normal. So if you're interested, you can go to the website that's marked below and see if you're interested in getting the course. Okay. So back to this, eGFR is estimated. It's a different terms, but it's really just, it's the same thing. We're talking about the same thing. How much is being filtered through the glomerulus at the point of in your kidneys. It's a mathematical thing, and it's designed based on your serum creatinine level, your age, your sex, and your race. Although I will say that they're working on redoing the formula to remove race from the formula and to just use some different factors. So more on that to come, but for right now, that's what they're using to determine it. And a lot of people think that eGFR gives them a percentage of kidney function or whatever, but it's really just a number, and we use a range, and it tells us what stage of kidney disease you have. So it's not the only test that we use for kidney disease. We use a urine albumin, microalbumin, albumin creatinine ratio. It's also used to screen people with chronic conditions. So those are things that your doctor might have done in addition to that. And then what sorts of things might cause you to have kidney disease or have a low GFR? And it can be diabetes can affect your kidneys, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease, family history of cardiovascular or kidney disease, all contributes to your risk of having kidney disease. So why should you get this test? And the important thing is to know that whether you get the test or not, you have kidney disease, so it's good to know. The test is very simple. It's just a blood test. Your doctor probably can do it as part of your regular regular labs that you get for the day or for the year. If you do have diabetes, you have high blood pressure, you have family history of kidney disease, then it's going to be good that you get this test and you kind of know where you stand so you can see over time how it changes. You might wonder how accurate the test is. It's really, it's an estimate, and it's sometimes dependent on your healthcare practitioner, because creatinine is part of the mathematical equation. It's important to understand that creatinine can vary. It is a waste product produced by muscles. So if you're pregnant or very muscular, your creatinine may be higher than the average person. UTIs, urinary tract infections, some medications can also affect creatinine levels. So you should, if you get back a result that shows you have a stage of kidney disease, you should also ask questions about what kind of medications might have affected it. How are those affecting your kidneys? Dehydration can affect that. So you want to make sure that you're not dehydrated, that you're drinking fluids. And then how often should you check it? You should look into checking it depending on, if you have family history, if you have a previous value that's lower, maybe every 6 months. If you're normal, you may only need to check it annually just to kind of make sure where you're at and what's going on. Some of the symptoms of the low eGFR, as your kidneys start to deteriorate or worsen with kidney disease, you can experience fatigue or, just exhaustion. You get additional waste in your body and your fluids, and that causes you to be fatigued. You might have swelling or inflammation, so your ankles are more swollen, your face, your feet. Those all are signs of kidney disease or low GFR. And GFR is kind of the opposite. So you want it to be high. You want it to be over 80 or 100. The lower it gets, the worse your kidney disease is. So you may find that you have increased urination, which can affect many conditions, but one of the conditions may be from the low GFR. You should probably talk to your doctor if you're waking up multiple times in the middle of the night with a lot of urination, unless that's normal for you. You might have dry, itchy skin. You might have some muscle cramps, but all of that together, you want to look at with your doctor and talk to them about it. So how does it work? It's basically an equation, and they use your age, your race, your gender, your creatinine levels, and it gives them an outcome. So it's really just a blood test, checking your creatinine, and then they put it into the equation. So you can drink more water. You can make sure you're well hydrated to make sure that your blood test is accurate. Being dehydrated can cause your creatinine to be higher, so you want to make sure you're not dehydrated. Thinking through what are, normal test results. So you've got your eGFR test result. Now you're like, what is the right number? What is a good number? So normal stage one would be 90 or higher, which means you're not having any issues with your kidneys or anything. Stage two is GFR of 60 to 89, meaning that your kidneys are, slightly impaired. It's considered a mild loss of kidney function. And it also means that you have, in stage two, as a dietitian, I feel compelled to tell you this, in stage two, you're going to want to eat more fruits, more vegetables, lower fat, try to lose some weight, manage your diabetes, manage your blood pressure, low sodium. You're not going to get into the restricting potassium, phosphorus, protein, salt, all that. You want to restrict salt kind of at this stage, but not everything else, because you can get a healthy diet, you can lose a little weight, and you can slow down that progression of your kidney disease. So this is a good number to know. What is an abnormal level or a low result is below 60. So stage 3A is like 45 to 59, 3B is 30 to 44. And you may be wondering why there's a stage 3A and stage 3B. And really, it's just the way that you kind of determine when it's time to go see the nephrologist and to break that stage 3 into kind of an early issues and a later issues as you're starting to progress towards kidney failure. Stage 4 is considered kind of severe, and so you have a range of 15 to 29. And then anything below 15 is stage 5 and is considered kidney failure, and you may need to be on dialysis or start preparing for dialysis or consider kidney transplant. So all of those things can, as it progresses, you should be aware of your options. You always should be talking to your doctor about how to slow the progression. Number one, what medications can you take? What dietary changes can you make? And then number two, as it progresses, what do I need to be doing to prepare for kidney disease, for kidney failure? So it's normal range for creatinine, you might wonder, is 0.74 to 1.3 milligrams per deciliter for adult men. Adult women, it's 0.59 to 1.04 milligrams per deciliter. That is just a general number, so that can depend on the lab, and you should look at your lab results to see the normal level of what they consider normal for that machine to be a creatinine level. It can vary a little. Again, if you have a certain amount of muscle mass, an additional amount of muscle mass, or you're pregnant, it can affect your creatinine levels. So it is possible to have a low GFR and not have kidney disease. So some of those things, you know, dehydration, if your creatinine is low and you might have dehydration, you could be have a low GFR, some medications. If you find out your GFR is low, you want to go to do some additional tests like the albumin creatinine ratio and microalbuminuria, looking in your urine for albumin. What happens if, you know, you find out that, oh, it does mean I have chronic kidney disease, then there are lifestyle steps. Like I said, when you find out your stage 2, stage 3, you've got diet, you've got exercise, you can lower your blood pressure, you can change your stress and your sleep management habits, cutting back on alcohol, reducing smoking or quitting smoking, and staying hydrated are all things you can do to improve your health. So make sure you're talking to your doctor, make sure you're getting it checked, and then make sure you kind of know what are the next steps. So if you find out your GFR is low, maybe stage 2, stage 3, what do I need to do to stop, to slow down the progression of kidney disease? So you can do that by, if you go to the course that I have shown below, or if you go to renaldiethq.com, you can search for articles about kidney disease and about your specific stage 2, stage 3, stage 4, and find out kind of what are the dietary recommendations. And going from that, you can do those things, improve your health, see what next steps you need to take. But I encourage you that this is a number you need to know, but it shouldn't be the like scariest number you ever get, but it should be a guidance number. So it can, kidney disease progression can be slowed down with medication, with diet, with exercise, and changing some habits. So going from there, it's important to try to improve your health once you know if you have some kidney failure. So I know I've been talking, I don't see any comments or questions. So feel free to put comments or questions below on this live and let me know what questions you have, and I'll come back and answer them. So thanks for joining me today. I really appreciate this community, and I appreciate all that you guys do, you know, and being part of the group. So thank you very much, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.